Hi, I'm Julie Davis with Blick Art Materials. Kinetic art is designed to incorporate motion. In 1913, Marcel Duchamp mounted a spinning bicycle wheel onto a stool to make what we consider to be the first kinetic sculpture. It required touch to make it move. Other artists have used motors, air currents, water, and gravity to get their art moving. Today, I'd like to show you how to make ArtOMotion. It's a simple, pulley-operated mechanical sculpture that's so fun to play with, your students won't even notice that they're learning design principles and simple physics. Let's start with the background. You'll need to use something really rigid. I have a piece of corrugated plastic, which I cut down from a larger piece. You could also use foam board, but this is more durable. Now, to determine the size and placement of the moving parts, measure and mark the panel, as I've done here. This will help you decide how large to make the gears or the rotating pieces of the sculpture. They can overlap one another, but not run into each other. So these will be about 5 inches in diameter. Now the gears can be made from just about anything. These are mostly done with poster board. They can be simple and straightforward, like this one, or somewhat more complicated, like this one here. I like them to look mechanical, so I've chosen to use metallic markers and metallic boards, but they can also be colorful and whimsical too. If I turn this one over, you'll see I've glued a wooden spool to the back side. I've also chosen to glue a couple craft sticks to the back just to give it some extra support so it doesn't warp or bend. Now we'll go ahead and assemble the sculpture. These pointed wooden sticks are useful for a variety of art projects, and today I'm going to use them for axles. It goes through the spools and out the front of the gear. Next, take a pony bead and put a drop of glue inside, then thread that onto the front of the stick. Set it aside to dry. While it's drying, go ahead and create the holes in the corrugated background. They need to be big enough for the stick to thread through. Another pony bead and another drop of glue. Thread it onto the back side. You'll want the spool to sit flush against the corrugated panel, but you don't want it so tight that it can't move. Repeat this for each gear. Now let's take a look at one that's ready for some motion. As you can see, I've used a variety of spool heights and trimmed the excess length of the wooden stick on the backside. Using a piece of nylon cord about twice the size of the background, I'll loop it around each spool going in the same direction. Now to keep the cord from coming off the spools, I've created a stop with a piece of wire poked through the corrugated background and bent around to the back side. Next, I'll thread the nylon cord through the stop on either side. And as a final step, I'll tie a bead or two on each end. I know that was quick, so if you want more details, photos, and illustrations of this project, please go to dickblick.com/lessonplans and download an instruction sheet for the ArtOMotion mechanical sculpture. You'll also find a complete materials list and the National Standards for Visual Arts Education. Thanks for joining us.